Good morning, your student, and good evening, your student. Nice to see you again. Today, I'm very happy to take all the students, Unit 11, Seeing is Believing. Learning objective for Unit 11 need all the students to know model of possibility auxiliary verb, need to think present verb and expressing attitude. But before lecturer start teaching Unit 11 for all the students, please organize yourself to know English, because English is a really good knowledge of knowledge. Knowledge is a treasure, but practice is key to it. Don't forget to watch the video 1, 2, 3, and 4. And next, all the students listen to video 5 that you take you Unit 11. Unit 11, we have the content, or we call the language focus 1, need students to know model of probability. 2, phrasal verb, and 3, expressing attitude. This the language focus for Unit 11 that lecturer need to take you. It's so important for all students. Each point that lecturer show the content right now have the real practice. Don't forget to read the relevant document, reading, listening, follow the tape script, and real practice for workbook Unit 11. Don't forget, after you have the theory, all the students need to have real practice. Don't forget your life, practice, practice, practice is the best way. Because after you have the theory, you need to have a real practice. When you practice and do follow the theory, you need to appreciate and need to evaluate to create the best point in our life. Okay, please, next all the students, please make sure the content that lecturer that I need to take all the students, 1, model of probability, 2, present verb, and 3, expressing attitude. Okay, 1. Model of probability. This grammar spot in your book, but lecturer need to complete for all the students to make sure more. Which of these sentences is the most sure? Which two sentences are less sure? Yeah, don't forget the question. Okay, all the students, please listen or read the 3 sentences with lecturer. It must be a duck. Duck or not, which one sure or which one less sure? It could be a duck, more sure or less sure. It might be a duck, less sure or might sure. Please consider yourself. If you're not sure, please read the book more and to answer the question. I think it's not difficult for all students. The above sentences all mean I think it possible that it is a duck. What does it can be a duck mean? Okay. Compare the sentences. When do we use like? It looks like a man playing the saxophone. The saxophone. It looked red to me. You look like your mother. You look hot and tired. This one we talk about. Look like, yeah, look red, yeah, look hot. Look at the example of the continuous infinitive being. She might be wearing a feather. You might be wearing a feather. Yeah, don't forget to make sure this grammar point for all students need to consider. It's so important. Okay, after all the students read the grammar spot, okay, our probability, model of probability, right now, real practice, the lecturer told you already, after we have theory, we need to know the real practice exam. Work with a partner, take turn to read aloud the statement and respond using the word in practice. And number one, I think I've lost my passport. That we use the word in bracket, bracket must or worried. You write, you must be very worried. Yeah, you must be very worried. Okay, number two, your phone ringing. We use my or Jen. Okay, right now you need to sing, you can speak. It might be Jen. Yeah, it might be Jen. It might be Jen. Number three, Paul taking his umbrella. Must rain. Round now or a student. Okay, Paul is taking his umbrella and Paul think that it's sure it must be raining. Yeah, it must be raining. Larry and Sally never go on holiday. You can or much money. Yeah, Larry and Sally, we use they. Okay, they can have much money. Yeah, they can have much money because Harry and Sally never go on holiday. Hannah's not in the class. You could or coffee bar. Could or coffee bar. Right now we use number five. Okay, she could be in the coffee bar. Yes, she could be in the coffee bar. Number six. Look, she fire engine. Yes, she fire engine. Must somewhere, and you just sing. Yeah, look. Three, five engine that must in somewhere. Yeah, there must be. Yeah, there must be in English. There must be a fire somewhere. Yeah, because we have three fire engine. Number seven, Tom hasn't seen Sue for ages. Can't go out together anymore. Yeah, go out anymore. Right now we said that they can't be going out together anymore. They can't be going out together anymore because Tom hasn't seen Sue for ages. Number eight, whose jacket is they? We use my or John. We just think that it might be John's. It might be John, you know? Because whose jacket is this? It might be John. And the last one of the student real practice with lecturer, you got top marks in the test. Yeah, you got top marks in the test. Okay, but you must be, and just, you must be joking. Yeah, you must be joking. Okay, that sometimes it's up to the meaning that you want to express with model of probability. It's very important for all students need to consider. Okay, this is like the grammar spot more. These sentences all express past probability. And what is the present? Mean past probability, what is the present? They must have been friends. They must have been friends. They might have caught the burglar. It can have been my ticket. And this one that we need to explain our student when we use must my, okay, need to express the past probability. What is the past of these sentences? He must love her very much. Yeah, must love her very much. He can't be at home. Yeah, he can't be at home. And we need to discuss yourself. I think you must understand each point. Remember mass also express application. What is the path of detention? I must call the police. Mean past simple, I had to call the police. Okay, if you want to make sure, please read the grammar reference, page 145. Okay, right now, modal verb of probability. Please make sure we lecture more and to make sure. Modal auxiliary verb can express ability 1, application 2, permission 3, and request 4. Don't forget to highlight in your book. Modal auxiliary verb can express ability, application, permission, and request. They can also express probability or how certain a situation is. There is an introduction to modal auxiliary verb on page 137. Probability in the present and future. Yeah, make sure. 1. Must and can express the logical conclusion of a situation. Must logically probable. Can logically improbable. Yeah. Logically improbable. Logically probable. Yeah, make sure must and can. We don't have all the facts, so we are not absolutely sure, but we are pretty certain. He must be exhausted. He hasn't slept for 24 hours. Must be exhausted. Exhausted means very tired. Yeah, very tired. Shu can't have a 10-year-old daughter. She's only 24. Okay, exactly. Okay, right now she cannot because she only 24. Cannot have 10-year-old daughter. He's in great shape, even though he must be at least 60. A walking his weather, you must be joking. And they answering, they must be in bed. They can't be out of this land. This express clearly, you don't have all the facts, you are not absolutely sure, but we are pretty certain. Next or sudden. 2, may or might or could. Yeah, this last you call or. May or might or could express probability in the present or future. In the present or future. May plus not is a negative. Couldn't is real in this issue. He might be lost. They may be stuck in a traffic jam. Probability. You could win the lottery this week. Who knows? Dale and Beth aren't at home. They could be at the concert, I suppose. Yeah, they could be at the concert, I suppose. We may go to Greece for our holiday. We haven't decided yet. May go to Greece. Take your umbrella. It might rain later. Just on the probability. I might not be able to come tonight. I might have to work late. They might not know where we are. 3. The continue infinitive is formed with be plus ing. The continue infinitive, don't forget, you must be joking. They can't still be eating. Peter might be working late. They may be coming on a later train. I could be sitting on a beach right now. Yeah, I could be sitting on the beach right now. All the students, please note the form. Continuous infinitive, yeah, with being, yeah, with being. And one more asking about possibility. Question form with modal verb of possibility are unusual. To ask about possibility, probability, we usually use do you think. Do you think? And before lecture, I used to tell you, I think you will, I don't think you will. I think you should, I don't think you should. Yeah, don't forget. Do you think she's married? She can't be. Where do you think he's from? He might be Portuguese. Yeah, Portuguese. Do you think they are right yet? They may have. Or they might have got stuck in traffic. Yeah, they might got stuck in traffic. Probability in the past. Wow, lecturer tell you already with modal auxiliary plus have plus verb 3 or plus participle. The perfect infinitive in a form with have plus participle. My, okay, that perfect, yeah. He must have caught a later train. Caught a later train because the first train, yeah, went out. They might have lost our phone number. Yeah, in the past, they lost my phone number. They might have lost our phone number. Did express have perfect infinitive in form with have participle. This form express degrees, yeah, of the probability in the past. The probability in the past too. Okay. He must have been exhausted mean in the past. She can't have told him about us yet. The letter may have got lost in the post. He might have changed his mind. They could have moved house. And this we call, okay, probability in the past. Continuous infinitive is formed with have been plus ing too. Okay, before we have plus be plus verb plus ing right now. She might have been joking. They can't have been trying very hard. Good. He could have been lying to you. Yeah, this is form continuous infinitive. Hello, all students. After all students study with me the model of probability, okay, the theory, how to know form and know how to use some already. Right now, all the students, please real practice with lecturer. Okay, need to consider which one you choose the best answer. Complete the deduction about Lux with the modal verb of probability from the box. Okay, from the box. Okay, don't forget it. Number one have done for you already. Lux must be the eldest child in the family. Yeah, we choose must be, choose one. Have been, you two, twice, might not know, may be studying, may get annoyed, can have, could be chiller, which one refer to. Number two, he, a younger brother called Clem. Okay, they said that he have, yeah, sorry, he must have a younger brother called Clem. Yeah, we use what? Number one, must have one. 3. Look friends. Yeah, look friends with column. Look friends may get annoyed with column. Yeah, may get annoyed with column. Look parents. Yeah, number 4. Very demanding job. Which one do you put or student? Okay, Luke's parents must have very demanding job. Yeah, very demanding job. 6. 5. Luke's for some exam. Okay, when exam related to study. Right now, 5. Luke's may be studying for some exam. 6. The parent that column has problem at school. Okay. Right now we use which one or student? The parents might not know that column has problem at school. Look a column mean look so when could be yeah could be jealous yeah could be jealous of column. Column, yeah, the last one, we left one, I think, can have many friends, can have many friends. Next, our student will be taking. Okay, match a line in A with a line in B. Okay, when you can match it, you make sure, but later I'll tell you some. 1, you can't be hungry. 2, she must be out. 3, he can't be English. 4, you must be very pleased. 5, they must be tired. 6, they must be know each other well. 7, you must be joking. 8, they can't be getting married. A, they have nothing in common. B, they've been hugging and kissing all evening. C, they aren't any lights on her flat or in her flat. D, nobody pays £600 for a pair of jeans. E, with your excellent exam result. F, we've just had breakfast. G, they've been traveling all night. H, with a name like Hendrix. Okay, right now number 1. Which one I want? You can't be hungry. Yeah, appropriate answer F. We've just had breakfast. She must be out. Yeah, she must be out. Okay. There aren't any light on in her flat. Yeah, any light on her flat. 3. He can't be English. Yeah, he can't be English. Which one answer or student? He can't be English with a name like Hendrix. Yeah, a name like Hendrix. 4. You must be very pleased, mean very be very happy. Yeah, very happy because. Okay. Which answer student number 4? Yeah. You must be very pleased with your excellent exam result. Mm-hmm. They must be tired. Why? Which one I want? Okay. Number 5. They have been traveling all night. Wow. Traveling all night. 6. They must know each other well. Which one or student? Okay. They've been hugging and kissing all evening. Because know each other well. You must be joking, said when. Nobody. Yeah, which one? D. Nobody pay £600 for a pair of jeans. Mm-hmm. They can't be getting married. They have nothing in common. Yeah, in common. They have nothing in common. This is If I didn't tell you, okay, I think all my students can do just tell you some to make sure. Okay, This one plays the verb, yeah, number two, yeah. You study model of probability already. Right now, all the students, please listen to lecture carefully, explain about the place of verb. Read the dictionary in three for two place of verb. Answer the question. What are the verbs? What do somebody and something and somebody stand for? Yes, somebody stand for someone. Which group of place of verb are separable? Which are inseparable? Yeah, this one you need to read dictionary, work something out. Work something out, we have two meaning, mean find the answer. To show something, example, I can't work out how to do this. To work something out means to calculate something, place of verb. I work out the total cost, mean calculate. Work out more to progress in a good way. I hope things work out for you. And to do physical exercise to keep your body fit. We work out to mass at my exercise classes. And this is a place of work that always lecturer always explain all the students have literal meaning and non-literal meaning or idiom. Idiom, yeah, idiom. And make sure. Make something up. One meaning means to invent something, often something that is not true. To make up an action. Two, to form something, the different group that make up society. Make up with somebody means to become friends again after an argument. Has he made up with him yet? Wow, after argument already. And this exercise for all students, complete the sentences with the correct form of one appraisal verb in exercise one, the lecturer tell you already. To complete work out and made up. Slap home. Worked out. Yeah, verb ed, worked out. Who committed the crime? That's a lie. You made up that. Yeah, you made up that. Yeah, you made that up. Yeah, you made that up. Afterward. Sorry? Didn't you? That's a lie. You made that up, didn't you? Number three, I know we argue a lot, but we always kiss and make up. Number four, don't worry, things will work out in the end. They always do. Number five, he determined to lose weight. He works out at the gym every day. Six, women make up 56% of the students in this university. Seven, can you work out this bill for me? I don't understand all those figures. This is so important that for all students need to choose from exercise number one to complete the exercise number two. And after all the students study place of verb right now, lecturer needs students to match. Yeah, many more place of verb are formed with out and up. Yeah, a lot. And match a verb in A with a line in B. Yeah. Make a verb in A with a line in B. Find out. So then find out what does it mean. Yeah, combine now, find out. One, find out mean what time the train leave. Yeah, find out what time the train leave. Two, break up. Yeah, break up mean get divorced. Yeah, break up with a boyfriend or a girlfriend. Break out. What does break out? Break out of jail. Four, eat up. Eat up. Four, eat up. Eat up all your greens and you'll be healthy. Eat out. Wow. Number five, eat out. What does it mean? Okay. Eat out in a Chinese restaurant. Number six, save up. Save up to buy a new car. Wow. Seven, sort out. Yes, sort out all my CD. Take up. Eight, take up gold. Nine, fall out. Fall out with a friend. Yeah. With a friend after a loss about money. Come up with, yeah, come up with a good idea. Yeah, a good idea. This matching after all the students, please complete the meaning that appropriate. And lecturer tell you, praise the verb, we have literal meaning or non-literal meaning. Yeah, non-literal meaning or we call it. And this one is use replace the word in italic with one of the present verb from exercise 3 in the correct form. Mean don't forget italic. You need to earn, you need to learn to relax. Why don't you start doing yoga? You start doing. Why not start doing yoga? Mean take up. Yeah, take up yoga. Two, he just thought out a brilliant plan to save the business. Okay, to save the business right now. Okay, which one italic? Yeah, italic. Threw out a brilliant. Yeah, threw out mean come up with. Yeah, you just come up with. Three, there's no dessert until you finish all your meat and vegetable. Yeah, number three. Finish right now mean you eaten. Yeah, eaten. Yeah, finish all your meat and vegetable mean you've eaten up. Number four. Anne and Tony are talking to each other. They must have had an argument, yeah, Italy. They have even have ended their relationship. You know, right now, had an argument means they have fallen out. And they have ended their relationship means, okay, they have broken up here. They have broken up. Mm-hmm. Number five. Did you hear the news? Three dangerous prisoners have escaped from the local prison. Okay, what does escape from right now? Mean broken out. Yeah, broken out. Broken out the local prison. You must learn to organize your washing into colors and white. Okay, number six, right now we to organize. Mean to short out, yeah, S-O-O-T, short out. Number seven, we aren't spending much money, so we can't buy a house. Yeah, and spending right now mean we are saving up. Yeah, we are saving up money. And the last one, have you discovered why you didn't get the job? Yeah, right now, discover. Mean find out, we change to found out, yeah, found out. Okay, our third study, praise the verb already. Right now, all the students, please study with lecturer expressing attitude. It's make all the students to know which one appropriate meaning for expressing attitude. Have please lecturer read the conversation from you for you, and we lecturer show the highlight of both for all the students. Have you heard about Sam? No, I haven't. Well, I haven't spoken to him myself, but apparently he was caught cheating in his maths exam. No kidding. I can't believe that. Does he have a problem with maths? No. Actually, maths is the best subject. Really? So, why would he cheat? He doesn't need to. Exactly. And anyway, Sam not the type to cheat. He must be very upset. Presumably, he's going to complain. Yeah, he's seeing the principal this afternoon. Obviously, he's going to deny it completely. Well, hopefully, the principal will believe him. Let me know what happened. I will. Personally, I think he'll be okay. I hope you're right. Cheer. See you later. Yeah. Finger crossed for Sam. Bye. The conversation have a student please choose the meaning for expressing attitude. Yeah, expressing attitude that you consider which one appropriate to answer feedback to someone interviewer or your partner that make conversation and ask you more. After you study expressing attitude, right now real practice with lecturer, which one you choose the best for expressing attitude. Here, choose the correct word or phrase, complete the line. Yeah, complete the line. Okay, real practice with lecturer, choose one. Choosing the correct word or phrase to complete the line. Did you hear about Marcus? You know, the guy who works in my office. Well, apparently, obviously, he's going to be promoted. Hello, student. You choose apparently or obviously. We sing. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, the best answer, apparently. Of course, to be honest, I don't understand why. Of course, I don't understand why. To be honest, I don't understand why. Please, all the students, hurry up. Which one you choose? 1, 2, 3. To be honest, the best answer. To be honest, I don't understand why. Exactly. Or personally, I think he's hopeless at his job. Hello, student. Exactly or personally, please. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, the best answer, personally. Personally, I think he's hopeless at his job. He never does any work. In fact, naturally, all he does all day is chat to his friend on the phone and drink coffee. A student, in fact, or naturally, please sing. 1, 2, 3. Okay, the best answer, in fact. All he does all day is chat to his friend on the phone and drink coffee. Unfortunately, or really, his death is next to mine. 1, 2, 3, or student, 2, unfortunately, or really. Okay, the best answer, unfortunately, his death is next to mine. Generally, or presumably, he'll move to another office now. Okay, our student. 1, 2, 3, generally or presumably. Lee? Okay, the best answer. Presumably, he'll move to another office. And now, so hopefully, or really, I won't have to work with him anymore. Please sing, our student. Hopefully, or really. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, hopefully, I won't have to work with him anymore. Anyway, apparently, enough about me. Which one, or student? Anyway, or apparently? Okay. The best answer, anyway, enough about me. How's your work going? Are you still enjoying? Okay, the answer, apparently, to be honest, personally, in fact, unfortunately, presumably, hopefully, and anyway. Yeah, thank you, all the students. Okay, thank you very much for listening to me carefully, and thanks for paying attention to your English classes. See you next week. Okay, we need to study unit 12 next week and the end of the unit that you study core English year one semester two with lecturer. Okay, goodbye.